Yo, this is the Scarcity Studios YouTube channel. Please don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe. This story involves the death of a young man. He's 18 years old. He was 17 at the time he died, was murdered. And his body wasn't found for several months due to the fact that Gary Hopkins from Enfield, Hartmoor Mews, had murdered him due to the fact of drug addiction. This couple is an example of do not take drugs. She doesn't look well. Gary Hopkins and Stacey Doherty are the two people that have been convicted in relation to the murder of Abdi Ali. Rest in peace to Abdi Ali. Hopkins was found guilty of three offences: for the murder, for perverting the course of justice, for not letting a body be buried. An investigation was launched when officers, acting on information received, attended a residential address in Enfield at around 2 o'clock in the afternoon on Monday the 27th of August last year. The body of a male was found inside the property. The body was eventually identified as Abdi Ali, who was 17. He was from Ostell Crescent in Enfield. He had been reported missing by his family on the 21st of December 2018. He was last seen at a family wedding on the 11th of December. The discovery of the body at Hopkins' home address in Enfield followed information provided to the police by a friend. The information led officers searching the address to find Abdi's body, which was wrapped in bedding and hidden in the loft. The friend told police that on August the 25th, 2018, she had gone to visit the flat in Enfield. Hopkins was angry with a man who was asleep on his sofa. He informed the friend that he intended to rob and kill that man. Hopkins claimed he had done it before and that the body was in his attic. So to even try and imagine what kind of crack psychosis this man must have been under to even think that and then say that out loud to somebody is just mind-blowing. Hopkins placed the ladder against the wall, encouraged an associate who was also at the address to look in the loft, and encouraged him to touch it as well. So he got him into the loft to have a look at a dead body, literally like a child would. The shocked friend would later be told that the body was an unknown Somali male who was about 18 years old, and he had been disrespectful while in the house. Abdi often stayed in the address because he was homeless, they said, and would sell drugs in return as a mutual agreement. But that doesn't seem accurate when Abdi was reported missing and he was at family weddings, so he clearly had a relationship with his family. So I don't believe Gary Hopkins' versions of events there. I don't believe Abdi was completely homeless. I believe he was probably just using a punter's address to obviously do his business from, being as Gary Hopkins robbed him for drugs and money. On the 21st of December 2017, Abdi was asleep on the sofa. Hopkins hit Abdi with a hammer. The hammer broke, but Abdi did not die, so Hopkins went into the kitchen and got a knife and stabbed him in the heart. Abdi was then robbed of cash and drugs before his body was cleaned up, wrapped in a sheet and black bags and put in the loft. After hearing the information, the friend attended a police station in Hertfordshire on the 27th of August. Hopkins and Doherty were arrested at their address on the afternoon of the 27th of August after officers acted on the information and found his body. Hopkins' account was that two men, known associates who dealt drugs, had been looking for Abdi on the day that he was murdered. They killed him, and out of fear, he and Doherty had left their children, returning home a week later. Hopkins continued to stick to his story and attempted to leave the interview room, becoming abusive towards the officers. A post-mortem examination took place on the 31st of August this year in Haringey mortuary. They gave Abdi's cause of death as blunt force trauma to the head and stab wounds to the chest. That is just horrendous. So basically what happened is this abused drugs so long that his mind is just frazzled. He killed this young boy for some drugs just because he was in his house. He claims it was disrespect, but yeah, I'm sure he knows what happened. And this is just a disgusting case. It is a very good example also to all these kids that are doing country lions and trapping, is to always be aware, because this man killed him when he was asleep. He was asleep next to him, peaceful. He must have felt secure. He must have felt safe. And the last thing he was there was safe. You just don't know sometimes, do you? Rest in peace to Abdi Ali. And please pay respects. Please don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe to Scarcity Studios YouTube channel.